the next session on operations research. In this session, we are going to discuss about the classification schemes of models in operations research. In operations research, models can be classified based on various criteria such as their nature, purpose, and the types of variables and constraints they involve. Here are some common classification schemes. The first one is deterministic versus stochastic models. Deterministic models, all inputs and parameters are known with certainty. Example are linear programming and integer programming problems. So suppose if you are talking about a product which is made of various ingredients and you want to calculate the profit on the product, so that will be a type of linear programming problem. The difference between linear and integer programming problem is that in linear programming problem, you can have numericals which are continuous in nature. In integer programming, they are just integers. Stochastic models incorporate randomness and uncertainty in inputs and parameters. Examples, stochastic programming, queuing theory. So in queuing theory, suppose if we take the example of a dentist which has many patients who would come to visit him per day. So when he is planning the number of patients, he has to maintain a time interval between two patients such that the patients do not have to wait for too long. Also, he would have to give an approximate time for the job that will be done on the patient. But there will be randomness because the patients would enter and leave at random time. Also, there will be uncertainty because there are times when a patient books a slot but may not turn up. So in that case, these kind of uncertainties are possible. Next is static versus dynamic models. Static models do not consider changes over time. Analyze a system at a specific point in time. Example, linear programming for a single period resource allocation. Dynamic models consider changes over time, often involve multiple time periods. Example, dynamic programming, Markov decision processes. So this is very self-explanatory as to what is static and what is dynamic. Linear versus non-linear models. Linear models, objective function and constraints are linear functions of the decision variables. Example, linear programming, network flow models. So when we talk about these two models, we will be considering that they are linear models and solving. Non-linear models involve at least one non-linear function in the objective or constraints. Example, non-linear programming, quadratic programming. In these two types, what happens is the objective function will be non-linear, and so will be the constraints that are applied. Continuous versus discrete models. Continuous models, decision variables can take any value within a given range. Examples, linear programming, non-linear programming. These are continuous models. Discrete models, decision variables can only take discrete values of integers. Example, integer programming, combinatorial optimization. Single objective versus multiple objective models. Single objective models focus on optimizing a single objective function. Example is linear programming with a single objective. For example, we are either talking about maximizing profit or minimizing loss of an organization. Multi-objective models optimize multiple objectives, often requiring trade-offs between them. Examples, multi-objective linear programming, goal programming. So suppose if you have two objectives, in that case, you have to strike the balance between the two such that you are not investing too much of money and also you are not losing out on money because you have not invested in the first case. So this could be a multi-objective model. Constrained versus unconstrained models. Constrained models include constraints that limit the feasible solutions. Examples, linear programming with equality or inequality constraints. Unconstrained models do not have explicit constraints on the decision variables. Examples, unconstrained optimization problems in calculus. So suppose if your problems do not have proper constraint, they are unconstrained, and most of the problems that we are going to solve will be constrained models. Analytical versus simulation models. Analytical models use mathematical expressions to represent relationships and derive optimal solutions. Example, linear programming, integer programming. Simulation models use computational techniques to model and analyze the behavior of complex systems. Examples, discrete event simulation, Monte Carlo simulation. When you talk about Monte Carlo simulation, you are going to take into account various random numbers, and accordingly you will decide on, say, the number of mopeds to be made and sent from the factory to the warehouse. So accordingly, you know, you're going to decide on the number. So they are based on certain simulation models. And when you talk about linear programming and integer programming, they are analytical models wherein you just have equations which you have certain algorithms to follow, solve it and get the answer. Exact versus approximate models. Exact models aim to find the precise optimal solution. Examples, linear programming, branch and bound for integer programming. Approximate models aim to find good enough solutions when exact models are computationally infeasible. Examples, heuristics, meta-heuristics like genetic algorithms, simulated annealing. So there are certain models which give you exact values, and there are certain which are going to give you computationally infeasible solutions. Descriptive versus prescriptive models. Descriptive models aim to describe and understand the behavior of systems without providing specific recommendations. Example, queuing models for analyzing system performance. Prescriptive models aim to provide recommendations for decision making to achieve specific goals. Examples, optimization models for resource allocation, scheduling. So the main difference between descriptive and prescriptive model is that in prescriptive model, it is already a developed model wherein you can make decisions based on it. And descriptive model is still trying to understand the system and collect the data. Queuing model is one of the examples for it. Input-output models versus process models. Input-output models focus on the relationship between inputs and outputs in a system. Example, input-output economic models. Process models focus on the processes and activities within the system. Example, business process models, workflow models. So when you talk about input-output model, you're focusing on what is the input and what is the output. But when you talk about process model, you focus mainly on what process is being followed and what activities you are doing in between getting the input and making the output available to the customer. Each classification scheme offers a different perspective on how models can be structured and applied to solve various types of problems in operations research. The choice of classification depends on the specific context and objectives of the analysis. So based on these various types, you have to decide based on your condition as to what kind of model you want to use for your own process, and then you will get specific outputs from it. So with this, I end the session. I hope you have understood the classification schemes of models in OR. If you have any doubt, please write to me in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon for latest video updates. See you in the next session. Thank you.